Welcome guys, welcome to Elena's Low Impact Full Body Workouts. We are JB Fitness, we are doing Pilates today. We have Loretta, we have Natasha, we have Donna. And guys, prepare your props. If you want to join us for the class, remember to read the disclaimer in the description box, just in case you're practicing the start your own race at your own discretion. So let's begin seated. I see you are seated here. Good. Have a seat up to the row, your shoulders to the back, legs to the front of the hand. You can close your eyes for a moment. Tune into your body. Good. Inhale forward. Exhale back. Twice a few times. And remember, if you have very tight hips today, place the yoga blocks under the hips. Good. And you move a few to the other side. Good. Your eyes closed if you want to. Good. Okay, sit up nice and tall. Take a deep breath in, hands up to the sky, and with exhale, twist to your right side. Look where it's comfortable. Good. Just a gentle twist. Keep your shoulders down, away from your ears. Slowly come back to center. Inhale up, and with exhale, twist to your left. Keep your shoulders down. Away from your ear, lengthen through the crown of the head. Good. Slowly down back to center. Inhale up. With exhale, reach to your right. Open the shoulder. Just a few circles. You will try to press with the left hip down into the floor so you're not lifting the left hip. You feel the stretch of the obliques. And then reach forward. And inhale. And exhale. And inhale, and one more, and come back to center. Good job. Please shake it out, shake it out. Take a deep breath in to the other side, stretching. Good. Going up, a few shoulder circles here. Good. Keep breathing. And then shoulder forward. Good. And then inhale, and exhale, punch more. Keep your right hip down in the floor. Good. So come back to center, really shake it out. We bring your right ear towards the right shoulder. Let's do a little bit of the neck stretch here. Good. And through the back, if it's comfortable for you, bring it to the other side. Good. And then in the center. If it's comfortable for you to do a full lunge circle, go ahead and do it. If you feel dizzy, slow it down, make it smaller, and do only a halfway. Halfway round. Okay, to either side, you can alternate. Good. Slow release. Shake it out. Okay, let's switch the bind of the legs. Good. Same stretch to the other side. Inhale up with exhale. Twist to your right. Keep the shoulders down. Good. Slowly come back to center. Inhale up. With exhale to the left. Good. And so I come back to center. Inhale up. And reach to your right. A few shoulder circles here. Notice the difference between the two sides. One side might be a little tight or a little more stretched out than the other side. Usually it's the side that you sleep on that is more stretched out, and you might notice that the obliques on that side tend to be a little weaker. They are overstretched. Okay, so if you are a side sleeper, try to sleep on the opposite side. Good. A few shoulder circles here.
If you're old, you have to switch sides all the time.
Yeah. True. And with this, branch forward. And one way to test your obliques is to do the leg lifts, like in hundreds, we do it on the floor, except for on the yoga block. Not on the yoga block, on the foam roller. You know that one, right? That would challenge your sides. You don't know like, where exactly you need to work. Yeah, because we tend to favor only one side. It's pretty common. So let's switch the legs. We will warm them up a little bit. Good. Do you want to do some leg exercises at the bar today, or you're fine?
Sure, you do.
Okay.
No.
Yeah, we want to do too much on the legs, because like everybody looks like everybody's tired today, so sit up nice and tall here. Just semicircle here, and then a rainbow. Try to move the low part of the knee is stable, and then the full range circle. Good, and bend extend, bend extend. I really love doing the leg work at the bar, because it really helps to strengthen the leg muscles, and then when you stretch it, it's like, oh, it feels so good. Good, let's open and close, sit up nice and tall, watch your posture, good, and shake it out. And switch side, let's do the other leg. Good. Yeah, try to move from the knee, what is it? I know you're moving from the ankle.
I'm moving the knee too.
Good, and then switch the side. Nice. from the bar. Take your line of hand weights for this one, okay? We will work on the upper body as well, okay? So with bar, we will start very slowly, like we did last time. Do you remember the tandu? Natasha, I think you were not here, but you can not remember. Okay, so we are going to come into the first position, you can see me, right? So, heels are touching towards the out of the side in a comfortable knee shape. So, you are opening with your hips, okay? And we are going to open the arm. We will hold it only, okay, here. It's going to create a little bit of load on your shoulder. So, try to bend the knee a little bit. And So, like that. So, you can see with the peripheral vision. So, try not to keep the elbow down, so it's like on the shelf, resting on the shelf, okay? So tandem the leg forward, leading with the heel first, and then you press into the toe, and then you drop the heel down, and then you breathe slowly back, okay? And again, good. Try not to bend the standing leg at any moment. You can remove this hand from the bar to check on your balance, okay? And slowly press, okay, release. Yeah, you will feel your shoulder, okay? So we will not do anything with this arm. If you want to later, you can bring it in and out just to help it, you know, go smoother. So let's go out to the side now, the same. Bring the heel down and then together. Again, open, press it into the floor, drop the heel first and then forward, okay, and again, out, drop, and towards the center. Okay, now release. Yeah, we'll have to shake the shoulder quite a bit because you're going to feel good. And now here, you're going to bring it forward. You can remove the weights, okay, like Donna is doing, perfect. Yeah, if this is too much, yeah, just bring your hands into fists because it can get a little intense. So now, leading with the heel behind, the arm goes forward, point your toe, drop the heel and then bring down. You can lower the hands. Okay, abdominals are engaged. Good, again. To the back. Drop the heel. So you're not actually shifting the weight. You're kind of trying to stretch the foot, okay?
Okay.
Lay it down and then you drag it forward, okay? Towards the center. And again, let's do two more. To the back. Good. Drop the heel. And this will stretch your leg. Uh-huh. And one more. Good. We are working on the ankle strength, Achilles tendon, something that contributes to balancing because then you can just stand up and, you know, balance. So these exercises are very effective. I know they're very slow and annoying, but they're very good, okay? So let's open out again to the side, go to the side, drop the heel, and bring it in again. Out to the side, drop the heel, and bring it in. So you're pressing into the floor, you're creating the resistance, and one more. Watch your elbow, and breathe in. Nice one, please. Okay, let's come into clear, shake it out a few times, shake it out. Good, drop your tailbone down, abdominals are engaged. Good, let's get into our other side now, and then we will try to balance, okay? So, changing side. Heels are together, toes are out. You can come into a slightly wide position if that's more comfortable for you, okay? So let's open the arm to the side for the bra. Pull the elbow slightly bent, like you have water flowing through your hands and dropping down. Good, you can see your hand with the peripheral vision. Let's go. Bring the opposite leg forward. Tandu, point your toe, drop the heel, and bring it back. So we are not disconnecting the toe from the floor. We are sweeping the floor with the heel first, leading with the heel, and then pressing into the toe, lift it, drop the heel, and in. And one more. Good job. Drop. And in. Release. Good. Shake it out. Nice job. Okay. So now let's go to the side. Good. Open the arm. And let's go. Open, drop the heel, bring it in. Try to stay stable. You can remove the free hand from the bar, place it on your hip for balance, okay? Out, sure you're not slouching forward. Abdominals are engaged. Shoulders are right above your hips, maintaining the posture. And let's go. Plie. Lift the heels. Relevant. And down. So plie. Bend the knees. Lift the heels. Relevant. Palm on your tippy toes. And down. So relevant comes from plie. You stretch your legs. Good. Try not to roll out with your ankles. Keep the weight towards the big toes. Up and low. One more and we will reverse it. Up and slowly down. So now elevate. Come on your tippy toes. Bend the knees. Good. Track in the direction of the big toes. Drop the heels down. And stretch the legs again. Up. Plie. Heels down. And stretch. Up. Plie. Heels down. And stretch. Up. Plie. Heels down. And stretch. Okay, release. Yeah.
That's how I feel.
Yeah,
for sure.
This is a good warm-up. Mm-hmm. Usually, this is how we start in ballet. So, let's switch back to the first side. Now we will try to through the floor, the same principle. You just go slowly and up, outside leg. The outside leg. So you go slowly sweeping the floor, hold, drop, and in. So through tendu, you lift and freeze, drop, and in. And if you want to hold the arm, just hold it here, okay? We are not doing anything fancy with it. So again, up, slowly down, and in. And one more, let's try, up, slowly down, and now to the side without sinking into your hips. So you can check your balance, you can go out, drop, and in, out, drop, and in. With the weight, it's going to be a little harder to maintain yourself there. Up, drop, eventually you'll figure it out, your body will figure it out. And one more, drop. And in. Nice. Now to the back. You can bring the arm forward. So up. Good. Again. Two. Nice work. And three. And last one. Let's do. Four. Try to keep your hips square. Nice. Okay. This one will activate your quadriceps, especially if you freeze and hold it for a moment. And then the inner thighs. When you go out to the side, adductors, subductors that are working here. Let's switch to the other side. We'll try on ear on the other side. Okay, so we're moving pretty slowly through this sequence. So let's open the arm out. You can remove the weight. And let's go. Forward. Freeze. You don't have to lift the leg too far. If you feel like you are overtaking your pelvis, try to keep your neutral spine. Low and down. Up. Good, Loretta, nice control. On the way down, go very slow. Again, up, slowly down, and then sweeping the floor. And out to the side, point, and in. Up, good, point, and in, up. Point, and in, and one more. Good job. Okay, take a small break with the shoulder. If you're doing the shoulder work here, and we will go to the back. The arm goes forward, okay? To the back. Try to spread out your hips, and you can release the arm each time, especially if you're doing the weight. Just make sure that it doesn't throw you off. Abdominals are engaged. Don't lift the leg too far up. Try to keep it straight, Natasha, okay? Straight leg. Straighten it behind. So you can reduce the range of motion. You don't lift it too high. But watch that it's going straight because the tendency is to micro-bend the knee here. Okay, so let's do the next one. You can actually drop the weight if you want to. We will try... we did both sides. So we will try to bring the leg behind. So we are going to release a little bit and then stretch. Release and stretch. Two. Three. Four. You don't leave the leg too far up. So you are actually not really kicking it. You are micro-bending the knee.
Oh,
and then you stretch it. And then you stretch. So you're not actually pushing it up. Okay. You're not pulling it up down at the same, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. You stretch, you bend, and then you straighten.
Point your toes.
Point your toes. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Always, always try to keep your hips square, okay? Hips square. Come closer to the bar so that you can protect your back. Engaging the abdominals, okay? Nice work, Loretta, nice work. Yeah, this one, I find this one very helpful, especially when you are working into your arabesque, because this one, also when you lift the leg up so that the leg goes straight, it helps, okay? Because a lot of times it's just like soft knee. In ballet, we don't really want the soft knee, but this is why we are modifying, okay? So come closer to the bar so that you reduce the load on your low back, you protect your low back with your abdominals, with your core muscles. Let's try to the other side, okay? Just bend, extend, 2, 3, 4, 4. Elongate your neck, elongate your neck. Good job. Okay, slow release. Good. Okay, shake it out, shake it out. So the next one I want to show you, this one is a fun one. So we're going to do the kind of like passer, it's called fondue, okay? So you bend the knee, you bring the leg up high here, and then we develop it forward. Nice, point your toe, point your toe. Then you bring it back in, you bend the knee, and then you go out to the side. I know, don't lift too high, you know? Don't lift too high, okay?
No.
Yeah, I know. This one, like, unless you have with ballet, you know, unless you have like external rotation of the hip, you can safely do it. Otherwise, keep your hip close, like sort of close, facing forward, so the knee is facing forward, okay? Don't externally rotate it if you can't handle it with the hip, okay? And then slowly to the back, okay? And straighten your leg, okay? Again, slowly bring it in, out to the side. Remember, the knee is facing forward, nice for safety. Bring it in. And then, this is one of my favorites, to activate the legs. Good, try not to sink into the standing hip. It's going to be a little bit intense. And then, out. Good, I'm trying to a little bit externally rotate, but I'm kind of used to it. So you feel free to, you know, like close the hip a little bit. Just don't sink into standing legs so that you can balance, okay? Let's try a few to the other side. Loretta knows this one, we've done them before, right, Loretta? Cool.
Yeah, we did it on the floor, too. We did it on the floor, too.
I know. So let's do it. You can help yourself with the hands. So remember, the standing heel, the toe is kind of in the first position. So the knee, when you are bending, the knee straight in the direction of the big toe, of the standing leg. And then you develop back forward. Try to check your balance. Good job, look at that, okay. Nice work, ladies. Bring the knee out to the side now, to the side. See if you can balance. Nice, and slowly. It's fun to implement the balance work also. You can lean slightly forward, but remember, abdominals are still engaged. Lower the leg down if you feel too much pinching in the low back, okay? Slowly in, out to the side, oh my gosh. Yeah, this one will burn your inner thighs like crazy. In, it's one of my favorites. Out, it's okay to touch the bar, just don't lean on it, okay? So that eventually you can work on balance. How are you doing? Okay, shake it out.
Actually, all of that hurts this up. Like all of it, like I feel the muscle up.
The closing,
both crunching. Both sides.
On both
do
sides.
Just feel it on this side.
Mostly that on weird? That side?
Yeah.
Well, it shows you like which one.
Yeah, this is
which
the other one. This one is not tight.
Yeah. It's tight or it's not heavy. It's weaker, tight. You know, because it's less flexible.
Yeah.
Let's do another one. It will help you to open up your hips a little bit, I promise. So this is called Eastern Tendu. Okay, so from first position, you bring your one of the legs, okay, let's start with the right leg. So you bring it in, so internal rotation of the hip, external rotation of the hip. So go slowly, smoothly, okay? Internal and external.
to remember always, okay? And then again, and out, and then out the side and hold. Slowly lower it down. Oh. So this will stretch you.
Yes,
this will stretch you a little more there. That's
yeah, we will stretch, Natasha, don't worry.
Yeah, it's just to check.
Yeah,
you know,
let's
like to check what needs more work. Okay, so another one, which is good, you bring into a roll the jump. So you bring forward, out to the back, without opening the hips. Good. And see if you can go on here to the back slowly. Don't leave the leg too high up. So we just keep it here. We start with the cross leg, the one that we started.
The same one. Okay.
Good. And one more. Okay, let's go behind to the back side. Forward and in, back, side, forward, in, back, side, forward, in, try on here, passing through, good, and again, to the back, side, forward, I know, see, yeah, this one is fun, right?
Describe that, I know you're thinking that.
I can't remember how to do it.
Oh. already, so sit up nice and tall. And when you do this standing exercises, your abdominals are also working, because when you're lifting the leg, your lower abdominals have to work a lot, you know, to protect your back and see if you can feel a little bit more. You're stretching to the upper back. So we come back to center. You can remove the yoga block, sit up nice and tall. You can micro bend the knees, slowly come all the way down. Inhale to prepare. And with exhale, vertebra, slowly, slowly, slowly. Nice job, Natasha. Look at that. Did you lift yourself without lifting the heels?
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. Yeah. Now I can show you a challenge. Okay, so let's go. Slowly, vertebra. You can bring your hands slightly behind your neck. You don't have to pull on your neck. So take a breath. And with exhale, vertebra, slowly, slowly, slowly. Yeah, this one will challenge you a little bit. Yeah, if this is too much, you can disconnect. Yeah, disconnect your hands from the hand a little bit. Yeah, like
it takes a lot. It's taking me a lot of months to do that.
It does. Yeah, you can take a ball if you want to and put it in front of you like this, or you can use the light hand weight if you want to. Say inhale and with exhale, keeping the head as close to the ball as you can. Good. This will also challenge you a little bit. But I'm amazed, you know, she's been only here for like a few months consistently, right? Yeah. Once a week, and then you can feel it.
The muscles remember.
Yeah.
They're coming back. They're like, oh yeah. We need to be strong.
Nice work, ladies. Good job. Okay. Up and over. Cool. Let's do a little bit of transversus abdominis. So we will get into our tabletop. We will stretch the abdominals now. So keep your yoga blocks close by. You can place them right under your wrist if you need to. Good. We will do a few getting downs here. So you inhale, release the belly. And with exhale, round your spine into your knees, so into your navel. Keep breathing. Good. And exhale. And one more. Nice. Okay, tap your toes, lift your knees off the floor, watch yourself in a neutral spine, and then extend the legs, come into a plank. Elongate your back, elongate your neck, maybe you wiggle back and forth a few times. Feel free to lower the knees down with what you need to. Try to activate your abdominals, keep your neutral spine, and we are going to do single knee dips, and then double, double. Try not to move your torso. You're just moving the knees. Good, again. Single, single. Nice work, ladies. Good last one, let's go. You're even stronger even with this one, with this plank. Okay, come to your downward facing dog. Release your head, release your neck. Good, feel the stretch here. Good job. Okay. And slowly, you're going to come to one side. Good. Make sure the heels, hips, and hand are in one line. So we will do a little bit of oblique. Loretta, just want to use your elbows under your wrist, yeah, under your forearm. Just a few times, okay? So let's go up and slowly down. Up and lower. So with exhale up, inhale lower. Keeping the knees down on the floor for magnification. Good. Okay, now stretch the upper leg. Just a few times. See if you can lift the lower leg a few times. Nice job, Natasha. Good. Keep breathing. Keep breathing. Okay, land that leg. And with exhale. So the back foot, inhale up. Exhale lower. Feel free to lower the lower knee down on the floor if you need to. Just a few twisters here. Three. Keep breathing. And four. Nice job. Nice job. Good. Yeah, okay. And slowly come down. Yeah, just a few. We're not going to do too many.
So I need to cut it because I took myself off.
Yeah, well, I like it. You could do it.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay.
I remember that when you just started, like, you couldn't even lift the lower leg. It's amazing. Like, it's amazing to watch your progress, guys. Okay, so let's switch sides. We will do quickly to the other side. Because I also want to show you slightly different exercises for the obliques, okay? So keep your hands, hips, and heels in one line. spine. Let's keep your hands behind your head here. Open your elbows wide, okay? Keep a neutral spine. And we're going to lift just one shoulder to one side while you keep the pelvic alignment. Slowly coming down. Take a breath. Oh yeah, you've done that one. And with exhale to the other side, keeping the knees in line with the hips. Don't move them, keep squeezing the ball. Working your inner thighs here. Good. Calm down. We will do just a few reps because we already did most of the obliques here. Slowly down. Take a breath and with exhale to the other side. Almost done. And release. Nice job, please. Good. Yeah, this is the alternative, okay? It works obliques just as much. It's more than internal obliques, though. Okay, so it works them on a different level, slightly, okay? So you're still going to feel the activation and everything. It just could be a good modification for the shoublier.
There is a lot of oblique exercises. I just wish my shoulder would heal.
Yeah, I know. I feel you. So slowly lift your hips up into a shoulder stand. I'm going to stay here for a moment. If you want to place the yoga block under your hips, feel free to do so. Otherwise, if you want to place the ball in between your inner thighs, you're going to keep squeezing the ball, keep your hips up. Good. So here we are working on gluteus maximus and inner thighs, okay? Squeezing the ball, you work on the inner thighs, and then when you push into the heels, lifting your hips up, you're working on your gluteus maximus, okay? So, keep breathing, just focus for a moment. And then eventually, like, release for a little bit and then see if you can go proceed again. One, squeeze, three, four, and up. Oh, it also works on your hamstrings. Good. Squeeze, 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 four, and five, and release. And last one, let's go. One, two, three, four, and five. Woo. I know, I love this one. Do you like it?
Maybe.
Maybe. I remember one day we did like four reps like in a row or something. You remember that class, right? Yeah, that was pretty crazy. Okay, so now let's walk into our hundreds. So start pulsing with the hands. You can lift your head, place the ball under your neck while you're still here. Might as well do the hundreds, right? So you inhale in through your rib cage and with exhale. And then if you want to start tapping, tap with one leg for 5 pounds. And then inhale for 5 pounds. Don't rush on the way up. Slowly down. Good. And with exhale. And see if you can go with a straight leg. You can reduce the range of motion. You can lift the leg a little higher so that you are not arching your back. Keep your neutral spine. Keep breathing through the ribs. Good job. This strengthens your lower abdominals, the pelvic floor muscles. Good. Nice work, please. I love the preparation for the 100 because when you get into the 100, it's like, okay, now you can hold it here, keep breathing. You can micro-bend the knees with both legs. Good. Because while you are working towards the 100, you are still exercising. Good. Keep breathing, keep breathing. Let's do one more. Set. And last four. Nice job. Okay, so breathing. Really, side to side. Good. Okay. Well, we did some of the hip quads already standing, okay? So we will do now, we will just get into the challenge. So
for you, ladies. You can just pass the ball close into the hands, stretch, and then you bring the ball again. Try not to lift your hips when you are passing the ball into your hands. So this could be a good modification. Okay, it still works your lower abdominals. Nice, for keep breathing. Good. And last one. Good. And we are going to do the corkscrew. So if you want to remove the ball, you lift your hips up. There's always space between the hips and the lift. Twist your right side with the hips. So the legs are facing to the left, and then you slowly land on that right side. And then you finish so quickly, micro bend the knees again. And slowly come back to center. Inhale up. Good, you twist.
Natasha, how are you doing?
Okay,
to the leg.
Good, you take a small break if you need to.
Yeah.
Yeah, this one is a little tricky, like lifting the hips up, preserving the space between the hips. So you're not actually collapsing here, but see, you try to like activate the abdominals while you're
the
still
flow, yeah.
Doing
I don't think
it.
My abdominals are strong. Yeah.
They will get there.
Yeah.
They'll get there. Yeah. That's
not
the palms and the other exercises.
That
you're doing it will help. Okay, and then twist forward to the other side. Let's finish it. Slowly landing. Good job. Okay. And let's clasp the legs. Lift yourself up. You don't have to touch the floor behind. See if you can roll up into your boat pose. Okay, ladies, you can try to do boat pose. Roll your shoulders to the back. Good. Keep your straight spine. Good. You can hold here. You can lower one leg up. Other leg up. Okay. Good. And if you want to clasp your hands, this is a challenging part of it. Slowly landing the legs down. Uh-huh. And then up and forward. And we will do just one on the other side, just with the opposite leg on top. So sit up nice and tall. Inhale. Up and over, switch the bind. And then...
You did it!
Yeah, look at that. Yeah, come into your boat pose if you want to try. But slowly, slowly, slowly. Coming down. Yeah. Some days it's just, it is what it is, yeah, you have to push through it and see like what, you know?
Yeah, push through it.
Nice work. Okay, let's work on a little bit on the back extension here. So let's get into a sphinx. If you want to, just you can stay in the sphinx, it will feel nice, I promise. So you can just stay here, stretch the abdominals, okay? Oh, and another, I can give you another exercise for the isolation of the hips, if you want to try. So you widen your legs a little bit, okay? And here you're going to, it's going to be fun actually. Try to squeeze the right glute. Yeah,
okay.
Focus on the right glute, squeeze it, release it, squeeze the left glute. Right.
Right.
Left. You have
right.
To really think
yeah.
About
it. You do.
Yes.
They both
want to
go at the same time.
They both want to go at the same time, exactly. This is kind of what we do usually when we are on the back, lifting the hips up and we are releasing into one hip, the other hip. But now we are laying down, so we can't help ourselves with the back muscles, right? We really have to isolate the glutes.
I like it.
This stretches your abs.
No, yeah.
It does stretch your abs a little bit. For the main extension. You leave heel up, okay? So you're going to press with the pubic bone down into the floor. See if you can push the heel up towards the sky, okay? Just a few times here. 3 and 4. Slowly release it, let's switch to the left, okay? Flex your foot and let's go with the left. 1, 2, 3. The belly is down on the floor. Slowly bring it down. Right. Let's do for 2. And release, switch left. Good. And try both now. So you bring both legs and you both go up, up, up.
Oh, is it cranking?
Now our butt's cramping. Look where you've done.
It's like, okay, I can do one at a time, but when I did both of them, my leg went.
Yeah. So, yeah, try to relax the rest of the body, just the glutes, isolate the glutes too. Keep breathing. 3 and 4.
Yeah, you are going to feel like if you keep up with this one, I didn't torture you too much with this one, but if you keep up with it, you're going to feel a lot of activation of the glutes. Uh-huh. So while you're watching TV like this, you're going to be like, oh, okay, I can do that, you know what
I have two dogs sitting on me while I do this.
Well, see?
try, okay? So we're going to come closer on the tippy toes, okay, this time. And see, try not to bend into your hips. So you're not boom, you're not doing this. You're bending into your elbows. And see if you can, lower the heel down on the floor, okay?
Oh, no.
Align it and lift the opposite leg a little bit.
Yeah, as soon as I try to tip it on my head.
Yeah, okay, that's okay. Don't worry then. Yeah, this one is a little more tricky.
Yeah,
okay. So Loretta, how are you doing on the other side?
I was sedentary for a while.
Me too.
I used to be
be constantly moving and moving.
And then switch the bind of the leg. You can bring one leg on top of another, see how it feels.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this. Jeez, you can do it.
I have some flexibility, but like my hips kind of locked up. I had a rear end accident. It's been maybe 6 years ago, and it was the fifth rear end that I didn't get five times in the rear, and that was like the straw that broke the camel's back because I get lumps now all in my muscles and
you
stuff.
You do foam rolling?
I roll. I use the ball. Yeah, I do all of that. I went and had a lot of massages, those deep, tissue.
Yeah.
But like she would get all the knots out and come back the next time, and they'd all be back again. So ever since then, it's just been really hard. But I haven't moved enough either. You know, you get hurt and then you stop moving, and then
it's even worse because it's freezing the scar tissue around it, and then if you don't flush it, you know.
Right. And so I think that's what I'm trying to get.
Well, it's good that you're consistent, you know. I really love the fact that you come, you know.
I love her too. I want her here.
I know. Thank you. Well, yeah, thank you. Watch after you go. So let's reach forward.
A cancer diagnosis changes kind of your outlook on things, right? Mm-hmm. So you're like, I'm not going to sit here and just waste away. I'm going to do something. So I'm doing it.
Just be patient with this. Don't do them every single class. Just don't be scared.
No.
Occasionally, I'll
you're not going to scare me. No.
Occasionally,
I'll keep trying.
Yeah, I'll throw them at you because they are really
good. Yeah.
You know, because then when we do balancing work and if you attend yoga classes or other classes, these are like the essential, right. You know, the slow motion exercises that you need, they really help to build up these muscles,
right.
You know? And they need time, you know, just be patient, okay? Cool, so great class, ladies. Thank you for joining.
Yeah, we'll see you soon, guys. Remember to please like and subscribe, and have a wonderful day, everyone. Bye.